haven't said in a while. And every now and then somebody has to tell you, well, don't say that, because you know that that is not going to come to pass, because you really don't want that. But if you leave it out there, it will come to pass. So you need to change that seed that you have spoken into the future. And for those of you who are shy and are kind of like in the closet about your joy and how you feel, not in the closet about that other thing that you was thinking about, but you're in the closet about your celebration of your purpose and your destiny, I have a little announcement for you. I need you to go ahead and get your praise on right here and right now and start saying something and putting some words in the air. This is the Coach's Corner, all pumped up. Why? Because we got to get you to the finish line. That's what's up. That's what's up. Make your day. Let the Lord make your day. Let the Lord make your day. And don't forget now, you're gonna need the negative and the positive. Don't be tripping. I'm only gonna stay positive. If something negative come your way, Paul says, man, we glory in these things. You know what that word glory in the Greek means? It had a connotation of a mirror. That means when bad things happen to me, I look best. I am anchored. I am settled. I am standing on the rock. When things are not going my way, that's when things are going my way. Because all things work together for the good for those that love God and are the called. I need some help right there. Ready, get ready. We're going to switch gears in just a few minutes. Y'all get ready. We're going to switch gears. I hope you're ready for the groove. The groove praise is coming up after this. Word I want to share with you real quick just came to me, might help you out. Stop putting sensuality and spirituality together and expect it to come out right. You get that? Stop putting sensuality and spirituality together. They are not together like that. Sensuality is carnal, meaning it's a physical thing. Spirituality is a spirit thing. Stop crisscrossing them and put your priorities right. First, get your spirit right. I need some help right there. And then double back with guidance, direction, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, and work on your sensual life. But a lot of people are working on their sensual life first and then step to the side to try to get some spiritual confirmation. It don't work like that, man. Whatever you do, you gotta always, always put your spiritual life first, man. Put your spiritual life first, man. I ain't fussing at you. I just want to encourage you, man. Don't try to put sensual and spiritual together. If you want to have the best outcome, now you're gonna have an outcome. You're gonna have an outcome. But if you want the best outcome, then whatever you do, put your spirit before your body. I felt that right there. We're going to take one more old time for the old time sake of choirs, and then we're going to come back with the new group.
Like a ship that's tossed and driven, battered by an angry sea, when the storms of life are raging and the burdens fall on me, sometimes I wonder why fortune seemed to pass me by. Then I say to my soul, take courage, the Lord will make a way somehow.
One of the things I like about this song is that we try to outwit God. You know what I'm saying? Like our mistakes is too big. That's like we go out to try to make the biggest mistakes and say, God, now fix that. Or we do the opposite. We so wallow in the mistakes that we make it's like we double dare, double triple God. But you got to remember one thing about God. God would not be tempted by man. If you want it fixed, then you call it what you want it. I need you to fix this, Lord, is the prayer. And then behind that comes the declaration, this will be fixed.
Come on, Durant. Let's hear you now.
Try to do my best in service. Try to do the best I can. Win or choose to do the right thing.
Be patient, the
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah, he working it out. He working it out. He working it out for you. For you. Yeah, 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 yeah. Say yes. That's what they used to say, Church of God in Christ. Say yes. Yes to your will. Uh-huh. And yes to your way. Mm-hmm. Yes, Lord, each and every day. I felt that right there. That's right. That's right. Say yes to the Lord. You know what I'm saying? Stop being so uptight. Let go and let God. You know what I'm saying? You know I'm going to encourage you. You know I'm going to encourage you during the weekend. Now. You know I'm going to build you up. So you can listen to this during the week, you know what I'm saying, so that you'll be able to get through the week. Because I'm telling you, that Monday and that Tuesday, Lord have mercy. That Monday. And don't you hate it when you go to the job, you know what I'm saying, and you're trying to do your thing and all of that, and folks talking about you get in there, you know what I'm saying, early, trying to be on time and everything, and somebody say, I'll be right back. You be like, where you going? You're like, I'm going to take a cigarette break. Man, you had all weekend long, man, to smoke a cigarette, man. You ain't been in here 7 minutes before you got to have a nicotine attack, man. Come on, man. Come on, man. We need to get the work done. We need to get Monday off good. You know, the old sportscast on SIBN Radio says you got to win the game in the first quarter, man. You know what I'm saying? So don't you hate that Monday grind, man. It's a little rough. You know what I'm saying? So I thank you so much, man, for joining us, man, right here on the Coach's Corner, man. I've been acting crazy. I've been acting up, man. It's probably time for me to have a silent lunch, as my last son says, man. It's probably time for me to have a time out, man, because I'm cutting up in my mind. So we appreciate y'all, man. We got some commercials coming up. I know we got commercials. They're looking at me here in the studios. I know we got some commercials coming up, man. But just keep it locked right here. The Coach's Corner Weekend Edition, man. This Coach.
Hey, listen to me real quick. Sometimes on the way to your destiny, people try to roll with you that you know ain't no good for you. You know, sometimes you just gotta let some stuff go, let some people go, let go some of the baggage, cause everybody can't go.
2103, y'all.
Destiny's calling, man, you need to make some changes. Get what it's got for you, that means you can go some places. If they all go left, maybe you should go right. Stay out of mischief and you will have a better life. If the trauma worth it, saying sorry for it, then it benefit you, doing what your friends do. Is the trauma worth it, saying sorry for it, it's a simple lesson for you to learn. Everybody can go. Separate your life. It's hard to grow. Everybody can go. Yeah, everybody let some stuff go. All you gotta know is that God says so. Everybody can go.
Everybody can go.
Where you need to go. Gotta separate your life. It's hard to grow. Everybody can go. Gotta let some stuff go. None. Don't need no negative, not even making progress. Don't let them pull you down into the dirty mess.
If the trauma worth it, saying sorry for it, then it benefit you, doing what your friends do. Is the trauma worth it, saying sorry for it?